You have certainly never seen such a scary elevator. A group of people entered the elevator. The elevator kept going up. Even the floor they pressed did not stop. When everyone was in doubt, the elevator suddenly went up quickly. Even turning off the emergency switch had no effect. Everyone started screaming in panic. It was at this moment that the lower part of the elevator suddenly opened. A group of people fell down. Only a few people grasped the railing inside. But these people didn't last long either. The elevator is still going up quickly. More and more people were falling. It was not until the elevator reached the top floor that it stopped. This elevator wasn't the first murder. A few days ago, when a group of pregnant women took the elevator, this problem appeared. As they went down, suddenly the elevator got stuck between the 21st and 22nd floors. The group of pregnant women fell to the ground by inertia. They pressed the alarm button and the phone calls were useless. These staff members want to open the elevator door to save the hospital, but they can't open it anyway. The temperature in the elevator was now getting higher and higher. There are two pregnant women because they can't bear it, were about to give birth. At this time, a guard came running with an axe. Because his wife was also in the elevator. Unexpectedly, as soon as the axe came, the elevator immediately worked, obediently brought this group of pregnant women safely down to the first floor. The owner of the building immediately contacted the owners of the elevator company Tom and JACKK, but these two professional staff, after thorough inspection, they ignore because they don't find any problem. So the elevators started to be used again. A blind man led a guide dog to the elevator, but when the elevator door opened, inside was an empty elevator tunnel. The guide dog didn't stop barking to remind him, but apparently he didn't understand what the dog meant. So he went in. One foot in the air, he pulled the dog tightly. This is the last life-saving grasp. Because of the difference in strength, he ended up dragging the dog down with him. Abnormal detection protection. Preparate to find the cause. The elevator door opened. As soon as he caught his eye, the elevator shaft was empty. The security guard shining the flashlight saw the guard dog that had just died. And at this time, the elevator suddenly bangs, directly closes. This elevator has become an ogre. It clamped down on the man's head. No matter how much he struggled, he couldn't pull away. Colleagues in the back ran to help, even with all his might. The elevator doors wouldn't move at all, and now the elevator was not stopping going down. Colleagues tried their best to drag him outside. Even his clothes are torn. Fortunately, the elevator stopped at the top of his head, but no one expected. This is just an elevator joke. It started going down again. The body of the guard was also forced down by the elevator. Immediately, the guard died just like that. The boss can only invite the elevator repairman again. Jack and Tom conduct the test. But no matter how they check, from start to finish, no problems were found. So Jack suggested to the owner to close the elevator for a week, so that they could easily check the elevator thoroughly both inside and out. But the boss didn't do it anymore. This building is a famous site. The number of people taking the elevator every day was more than 30,000. If it is closed for 1 week, it will create an immeasurable loss. So the elevator works normally. These two were skating. They ran into the underground garage. One of them was not careful and was hit by a car and fell on the ground. He was massaging his injured leg. At this time, the windshield wiper of the car next to it stood up strangely. The back elevator door suddenly opened. He was sucked into the elevator by tremendous power and then flew up. Upon reaching the 86th floor, the elevator doors opened. He suddenly flew out of the elevator. He broke 12mm thick industrial glass and fell in front of his friend. Jack received got the message. He was at home looking at the elevator drawings. He want to see where the problem is in the end. At this time, reporter Jane came to find him. She took out a videotape. Inside there's a video recording the incident of the poor guy. What happened to that guy? The strange thing is, from the basement parking lot, that guy was sucked into the elevator. On the 86th floor, he was thrown out of the elevator. Time in between, the elevator only takes 2 seconds, but the normal elevator operation time from the first floor to the 86th floor needs at least 42 seconds. They decided to do a thorough investigation. Jack and Jane worked together to find the owner of the elevator, Tom. Looks like Tom is trying his best to hide something right now. He just said he didn't want to involve the two of them, so left quickly. The two of them can only continue to conduct the investigation in another direction. Soon they made a new discovery. This elevator designer, Nick, has a huge problem. He decided to conduct an investigation in this direction. But unexpectedly, something scarier suddenly happened. This is absolutely the elevator that makes you feel the most scary. A group of people took the elevator, but when they reached the floor they pressed again. They didn't stop. Everyone began to doubt. At this time, the elevator speed was going up faster and faster. Turning off the emergency power supply doesn't work either. The elevator went up non-stop. Now people were confused and didn't know what to do. The bottom of the elevator suddenly opened. A group of people fell. There were only a few people clutching the railing, but it didn't last long either. Everyone fell one by one. The elevator was still going up until it reached the top floor. The elevator stopped. The incident this time, all staff in the elevator were in accident. This incident shocked even the president. The president ordered a thorough investigation of this matter, because to investigate clearly the cause, Jack silently entered the interior of the elevator, checked it carefully, from the bottom to the top of the elevator, gradually go up. He discovered a large amount of mucus before his eyes. When he was about to continue with the investigation above, the military outside had cut off the power. He could only hold onto the elevator cable that kept crawling upwards. In front of a very large bucket, the mucus was coming out from here. He opened the iron box. Inside was a heart-like object. This is the consciousness of the elevator. Correct. He stabbed it with a screwdriver. The elevator suddenly started to catch on fire. It started to explode, falling steadily from above. Jack ripped the elevator cable. He escaped danger once. Seeing that Jack was not injured, the elevator continued to attack for several rounds, almost killing him. He quickly crawled out of the elevator to steal a rocket launcher from the military force. He was about to shoot the heart of the elevator. A gun pointed at him. Turns out it was the elevator designer Nick. He's transplanted an animal's head into an elevator. That's why the elevator has a sense of murder. The two immediately fought. Compared to Nick, Jack was not his opponent at all. Soon Jack lost. When Jack almost got kicked in the elevator by Nick, Jane was here. She pointed a gun at Nick. The rescued Jack now also picked up the cannon. He wants to shoot the heart of the elevator. Nick shielded the elevator door. He didn't want his lifelong commitment to be destroyed. When three of them were arguing in the elevator, suddenly reached out a rope wrapped tightly around Nick. Jack, who was closest to Nick, was also pulled by a rope around his ankle and pulled into the elevator. Jane took the opportunity to kick the rocket launcher over it. Jack picked up the cannon and shot this heart. He was immediately shot out. Nick became the last to be killed by the elevator. In the end, Jack and Jane are usually together. That problem has come. Have you or the person next to you ever had an elevator problem while riding the elevator?